In honor of my first work anniversary as a programmer, I like to share with you the things I do at work para kung may balak ka mag-apply sa gitong klaseng trabaho, eh alam mo yung mga kaharapin mo. So stay tuned. Hello everyone, my name is Mark Vermeer. I have been working as a software engineer for a year now, and I must say that taking this job has been the best decision I made for myself. Itong job kasi na ito ay entertaining, challenging, and fulfilling at the same time. Challenging in a sense na nasasatisfy nito ang cravings ko for learning every day. And if you want that, then you come to the right place. In this video, I'm gonna assume na you're a student taking a computer degree na curious lang kung anong ginagawa ng isang programmer on the job. Or pwedeng isa kang freelancer or a fresh grad just checking out. So let's start with the scenario. Let's say na hired ka na, and today is the first day of your work. You might ask yourself, magko-code na ba ako agad? No. Anong i-code mo kung hindi mo pa alam yung pinaka-flow ng company? So expect na in your first few days, dadaan ka muna sa tinatawag na onboarding process. The onboarding is the phase wherein ipa-familiarize ka muna ng team sa software product na dine-develop nila. Kung on a scale of 1 to 10, gaano na siya katapos? At kung anong magiging role mo sa completion ng project na yon? Dito rin i-discuss sa'yo kung ano yung mga tools and technologies na ginagamit sa pag-program. Kung ano yung mga programming languages, mga frameworks, and so on. The onboarding phase is unique to every company, so I can't tell you any more about that. But the essence remains the same, which is yung ipa-familiarize ka muna sa mga bagay-bagay bago ka isabak sa pinaka-real deal. Once na ma-feel na ng team na ready ka na, you'll now move on to the next step, which is yung setting up your environment. Dito ka na uutusan kung ano yung mga need mong i-install, kung ano yung mga need mong i-configure bago ka makapag-program. Dito rin ibibigay sa iyo yung mga necessary accesses, like bibigyan ka muna ng local copy ng database, pati rin ng code base, which is actually isang katutok yung laman. But don't worry about the code base. They don't expect you naman na ma-familiarize yun in a few weeks. No one does. If you do, are you even a human? The third phase is yung bibigyan ka na ng mga smaller tasks. These tasks may include renaming of incorrect field names, or adding a table in the database, or pwede rin CRUD activities. CRUD, by the way, if hindi nyo pa alam yung term, stands for Create, Read, Update, Delete, which is mainly the basic operations in a database. For example, suppose na meron kang object na order. In CRUD, dapat able ka to create an order, read all the details of the said order, update its information, and of course, the capability na mag-delete. So, ganun mostly yung mga CRUD activities, and ganun pa usually yung mga una mong ma-encounter na tasks. And of course, after ng mga smaller tasks, kung medyo tumataas na yung confidence mo about sa knowledge mo sa system, then you can transition to the bigger tasks. These bigger tasks may include updating a workflow, adding a new feature to the system, taking on tasks na weeks or months ang expected na abutin bago matapos, and of course, bug fixes. When you say bug, these are smaller parts or bigger parts of the system na they are not behaving the way they're supposed to. Pwedeng they could be caused by a missing condition, or unhandled exception, or anything na responsibility mo na siyempre alamin. And in this phase, since lumalawak na yung kaalaman mo dun sa system or sa software product ninyo, expect na tatanungin ka na nila sa mga ideas mo sa meetings or sa mga plannings. Makikipag-interact ka na sa mga people. Yeah. Lastly is for the later months and up, which is yung bibigyan ka na ng mga priority tasks. When you say priority tasks, these are the tasks na dapat matapos depending on their priority. Merong mga tasks na dapat within a week matapos na, meron ding mga within a day. But don't fret because ina-align naman siya kung kaninong dev siya dapat mapunta. For example, si dev na ganito is madalas sa ganitong klaseng feature. Eh nagkataon dito rin nagkaroon ng bug, so expect na malaki ang chance ang sa kanya mapunta yung task. So ganun yun. So there you have it. To summarize, ito yung mga possible mong maging responsibility. First is yung mag-add ng new feature. Second is mag-fix ng mga broken parts. Third is to search for places na pwedeng pagtuguan ng bug. And to kill that bug before that could even cause a problem. That's basically my life for 5 days in a week. And it's fun. Trust me, huwag kang maniwala sa mga nagsasabing stress lagi mga programmers. May nakikita ka bang stress sa pagmumukhang ito? I doubt that. Before I end this video, a quick shout out to this guy, kay Jobert Tige. He's a student from the school na tinuturuan ko before and a new subscriber to this channel. Tularan niyo siya. Char. Thank you everyone for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. I post new videos every Sunday, so if you wanna be alerted as soon as I upload, ring that bell button. Be sure to follow me on social media. I'm on Twitter, Instagram, and I also write stories on Wattpad. Check that out. That's an order. Charot. Have a nice day. Bye.